We have specified the governing equations. Now let's specify the boundary conditions. Here's my slide showing the boundary conditions at each boundary. So what we'll do is look at the boundary condition that we need to set and then go into ANSYS and set that. Let me start with the right boundary. Now, tau xy equals 0 comes from the tangential traction being 0. ANSYS by default sets the normal and tangential tractions to 0. That's the default boundary condition. So tau xy is already is set to 0 because the tangential traction is set to 0. The normal traction is also set to 0. So right now it has sigma x equal to 0. Let's change it to sigma x equal to p, and p is 20,000 psi in our problem. So I'll go into mechanical and highlight static structural in the tree, and that gives me, you know, the boundary conditions and the body forces that I can put. And I'll start with loads. And before that, let me make sure that the units are, you know, US customary. It might be metric by default. Okay, so select the right units and then go to loads, pressure, okay? And I need to select the right boundary. So I'll zoom out here using zoom to fit. And in fact, I can go to a wireframe view. So I'll say view wireframe, and that way I can see the right boundary nicely. And I can click on it and I'll say apply. Okay, so I have the right boundary selected, and the magnitude of that normal traction is minus 20,000 psi, and the minus is because it's out, you know, it's pulling away from the boundary. ANSYS by default, the pressure is into the boundary. Okay, and ignore this ramped, it doesn't affect linear, you know, in this particular problem, which is linear, so you just ignore the ramped and just focus on this value, 20,000 psi. If I go back to my boundary condition slide, okay, so now I have this boundary condition at the right boundary. Let me go to this boundary. Now here, again, tau xy is equal to 0. That comes from the tangential traction, and ANSYS already has that. So what I have to do is set the this condition, which is a displacement condition. As I've noted before, you know, that's really filters down to a condition on the derivatives of the displacement. That's a condition on the displacement. And let's set that equal to 0, v equal to 0. So I will go to supports, displacement, and I will select the bottom boundary. And just we are setting the y component equal to 0. Okay? And we have to interpret that as v equal to 0 at the bottom boundary. So I'll right click and I'll say rename v equal to 0 at, I can just say, right boundary. That way, you know, that's how we need to think about it. And in fact, let me go and rename this too. I'll say right click, rename. I'll say normal traction at right boundary. Okay? And say enter. And then if I go here, now this is basically a free surface. That's where these conditions come from. Now ANSYS works in Cartesian coordinates, but it'll, you know, it'll use this. You can convert it to conditions on the stress components in the Cartesian coordinates, and ANSYS will do that. So I don't need to do anything over here. And at this boundary, again, tau xy equal to 0 by default. So I just need to set u equal to 0. Let's do that. And I'll do this a little bit differently than v equal to 0. So what I'll do is I'll say supports, frictionless support. And the frictionless support essentially sets the displacements normal to a boundary to be 0. Okay? So I can set, in this case, u equal to 0 that way. So let me remind myself that that boundary condition is u equal to 0 at left boundary. Okay, and Then over here, again, you know, I basically have a free surface, so the boundary condition, the default boundary condition is what I have. That is all there is to set the boundary conditions. There's one, you know, one thing I wanted to note here. So right now, you know, ANSYS has the right governing equations and boundary conditions. Now, if I go to the surface, there is a thickness setting. Okay, that's not right. That's, you know, that's 1 meter. And this confuses students. Like, why do I not have to set the right thickness? So let me explain that. In fact, if I go to the mesh, and let me go to view, shaded exterior and edges, and if I go to an isometric view, this, you know, it's showing me a visualization of that 1 meter thickness. Let me change the thickness to something that's not that large. So I'll just say 1 inches, which is not the right thickness. Okay, so it's showing me a 3D view, and this confuses students. It's like our model is 2D. This is just a 3D visualization of a 2D model. Okay, so the way you need to think about this is 3D visualization of 2D math model. And in fact, you know, here the visualization is not necessary, so I can just turn it off. I can come here and say view and turn off thick shells and beams. Okay, so it turns off that visualization, and I can look along Z and over here. Now, the thickness would matter, would come into, you know, it doesn't come into the governing equations, but it can come into the boundary conditions if your the force at the right edge is given in terms of, you know, a force rather than force per unit area. In that case, to get the normal traction, you need to take that force and divide it by the area, which is that length times the thickness. But in this case, we're given the force per unit area, so it, you know, if I change the thickness, it's not going to affect that boundary condition, which is why the thickness doesn't matter over here. So essentially you can think of as, oh, the thickness doesn't affect the governing equations or boundary conditions and doesn't enter the mathematical model, so I don't need to set it. So I won't set it here. It turns out it can affect post-processing when you're just looking at reactions. So when you look at reactions, we'll go and set the right thickness. But right now, you know, we don't need to do that. So ANSYS has the mathematical model, and it has a mesh on which it can do the numerical solution and get the displacements at the nodes. That's what we are going to do next. But before that, let me go to the project page and say file, save, and then I'll say file. I'll also overwrite the WBPZ that I have. Okay, I'll say yes, replace. That means my WBPZ is also up to date.